Hey everyone, I wanted to showcase how you can use 3D models and embed it into your Webflow website using CMS from Webflow, Blender, and Google Model Viewer. I have a CMS collection called 3D models. And basically, I have a drop-down list of information and you can select a project. So if I go into settings here, it's pretty much the same thing as any other CMS, but instead I'm injecting custom information into the embedded code. And the reason why I want to show the case of this video is because I haven't seen any YouTube video that really talks about how to do this. So I have an order that's the way it's going to present in the collection of right here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, the model link. So that's going to be the embedded 3D model poster. That's the thumbnail. So like once I load into here, it's going to show a thumbnail before it actually is interactive. So in here, there's actually an editor. And what you can do is click and drag a 3D model in here. So say you're working in Blender. So you go to export, GLTF, and then go into model viewer. So you see you have a 3D model here. But there's actually a step that you can do before this that'll make the file even smaller. You can drag that into here and see how it's 5.6 megabytes. So if you expand the script, make it 512 by 512. Go to run. And once that's done, Draco again. And still under 1 megabyte, which is great. So drag this into Google Model Viewer. This is the editor. And from here, you can see that there's already zoom capabilities. This is the tab that you're going to use to affect how much you can rotate via the top, via the bottom, and see how there's no faces here. It's probably not useful for the user. It's going to feel more catered if you can kind of minimize the controls. So it doesn't have to be 360 degree rotation. And if you twirl this down, you can see yaw. This is yaw. Go to pitch, which is up and down. And the sweet spot for me is typically around 40 or 60. If I go to 60, it's going to be even less. So 40 is about right. I think 85. And then you can go all the way around. And if you want to have some type of zoom capabilities where you can zoom in and out, but you only want it to be a certain zoom in level, like let's say that I just want it to be like something like here, set minimum, and then zoom back out. Or instead of zooming back out, you can hit reset framing and hit current as initial. And then you just go here, download your poster, and that's going to capture that pose. And everything else is going to be in here. So if we go to Webflow, and our collection's already good, I'm just going to make a test file. And for this thumbnail, this is basically a modified version of that poster that we downloaded. And this is actually a square-shaped thumbnail. So what I did was I created a 512 by 512 artboard inside of Figma. And I keep a white background so I can see where that's kind of placed. Because like some of these screenshots you can see aren't really centered, so you have to kind of turn this on to see what feels best inside that thumbnail. And there's a plugin called WebP Exporter that's going to make your file a lot smaller. And see, that's 10 and 9 kilobytes, which is fantastic. So I think there is a limit to how many projects you can have. So this could be project list 1 for now. And there is a limit to how many fields you can do. So see that there's 30. I'm still going to do another option. So I'm going to be project list 2. And then option 1 is going to be test. Project list 2. Or just keep this for expanding my projects. Save collection. And then go into regulator 2. Pick test. So the order is going to be 1. Doesn't really matter because that's the only one. And this is going to be the link back button. So if you go here, the link that's associated to this. You can see, I'm gonna move this over. If I hover over this, you can see at the very bottom left, it says Barry Art Museum, and then hash or pound grid dash collection. And I think a lot of the other ones are like 3D dash models. And that's all based off of the reason why there is that hash is that I'm wanting it to go back to this section because I think the user's intent to go back is to potentially go back to where they were previously instead of start at the top. Section ID grid collection or 3D grid collection. So the ID is why we have that hash, that hashtag or pound. And that's all created based off of, let's go to save. Go to that page, Barry Art Museum. If I scroll down to that section and go to this gear, you can see the ID I created was grid collection. So that's how you're able to do that. And we're going to create a duplicate page. So let's just say we're doing Barry Art Museum 2 or test project. And I want it to be just lavaspit.com/test projects. Hit create. So I'm going to go to here. Copy this because I know that works. And then change this in front of the hash. Keep that a hash. And it is very important for accessibility to make sure that any image that you have on your website that you have some description. Unless it's maybe an icon, then you could set it to decorative. If it's just like some graphical element that doesn't have any like really too much information, copy that. And then, so this is a good thing to note is your 3D models inside of Webflow, they're only gonna accept TXT files and based off of the code, it's gonna know to translate it back to GLB. Use that and then move in. And then we're going to go into here. And same thing with images as 3D models. I just want to make sure that everything is accessible to screen readers. So I can copy here and then add that 3D model here. And next thing we want is the WebP. I'll go ahead and add this here, 3D model. Hit save, go back to here, get that poster. Mouse wheel is glitching. There we go. So from here, this is where we can start adding artists. So let's just say, for example, I want to put who created this 3D model or who made the 3D process portion. So I'll put, and then do we want it visible? Yes. So for title 2, you could probably put like poly count. You can see 4,432. Dimensions, we could probably put file size 100. And 87 kilobytes, and that's visible. And now this is everything from Google Model Viewer, all that code that we kind of modified inside of here. So minimum camera orbit, max camera orbit, minimum field of view, and the field of view is 30. Auto rotate means that once the user goes into that view, if you don't press anything, it's going to slowly rotate all the way around. And then autoplay is for models that have 3D animations. So I'm just not going to include that. And that should be it. I'm just going to select that collection and then filter it by project list 2 and test. And that's that one right there. Done publishing. So now we have LavaSpit test project, and there's your 3D model. So if I click in there, see how it showcased that thumbnail, that poster, and then there's a little bit of dimming. So I think that actually has to do with the lighting. There's the shadow intensity and where's that exposure 3D models template. If I double click into this embed, this is all the information from Google Model Viewer, and then download scene. This is everything that you'll need. So there's actually CSS in here. There's custom styles. If I hit enter, that's all the CSS that I'm styling for Model Viewer. So you'll just want to make sure that you have that CSS embedded in some way on your page. And it's super helpful for a dynamic use case because you only have to copy and paste it once or modify it once, and it's going to be incorporated in everything for that collection. So actually, let's go back to the custom code. This is how I was able to get all this to read with the CMS CMS collection. If you go to add field, this is all items based off of that CSS collection that you're able to add in. So see that field of view, camera orbit, max field of view. So instead of typing in a set number for every 3D model, this enables you to make it custom for every single one. So everything else that's in here that's already preset, like the shadow intensity, the exposure, those could be custom fields where, you know, you want something to be a little bit brighter, a little bit darker. You could set those as a CMS collection item that you type in a number. Say you don't want to have camera controls, that could be a boolean. Similar to auto rotate, where it's either typed in or not typed in. Camera controls could be the same thing. And loading's eager. That could be lazy load or eager. I think there's another option that could also be a custom field. And that's basically about it. I hope that this was helpful. Let me know if there's any more information that you'd like to see, any more details. And take care. Happy 3D modeling and incorporating on your website. Bye.